the need to control information, the need to keep people from knowing, the need to know knowledge as power, secrecy as power. This has been a fundament of our culture as we know it.
And on, the beat goes on. And on, the beat goes on.
The corporations have eventually, since the 30s, monopolized control of media and flow of information.
Most media in the world today is owned by large operations, large corporations or entities.
Television is a virtual hippie.
Herr Goebbels would have cut off his saluting arm for television.
You don't have to be some Marxist wet blanket to believe these things.
They don't want actually television to be a tool of empowerment.
Corporate ownership influences content necessarily, and that's because for General Electric to use NBC, one of its assets, to be critical of another aspect of General Electric, that's anathema. Corporations don't do that. They don't attack themselves. They don't portray, they're not going to work actively to portray themselves in a negative light.
Without the corporate filters.
And the only way change, radical change, will come is through numbers. How do you get numbers? You get numbers by organizing people. And you organize people by educating and radicalizing them.
Get down, everybody!
All that is possible. I mean, there's nothing... I'm not pessimistic about human future unless people do nothing.
But these people in Indonesia can kill upwards of a million people, and it barely makes the news.
Don't swallow the dreams or the nightmares. Live for yourself, not in yourself. But it won't be easy, and there can be some very ugly chapters, but it's worth educating oneself.
Evil would always have its appeasers, but the challenge for the truth seeker is to continue to uphold the truth and challenging evil in all its ramifications.